Hello, I'm Mr. Arnigan, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity, and Nanak is the second coming of Jesus. And he preached gospel to the perfection, and he left no stone unturned. Here I am rendering exposition of St. Luke 12, verse 39-48. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Par Brahm, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call SATGURU, Jesus, according to St. Luke 12, verse 39-48. Jesus said to his twice-born brethren, stroke workers, and not the once-born disciples of the rabbis. Remember, the root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline the natural boys by teaching them the moral law of Moses. That takes them to the kingdom of heaven. And in Jesus we have the royal kingdom of God, which is inside us and not outside. So this is the difference between the two. The kingdom of heaven and the royal kingdom of God. This is the kingdom of heaven of the rabbis. And this is the royal kingdom of God, which is in your heart, where the gospel treasures are, where the gospel gets written. Gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart. I will make a video on this one tonight. So this is the royal kingdom of God, which Jesus ushered in. This is the kingdom of heaven of the rabbis, seen in law and order. That is how they get disciplined, natural men. Here we are twice born people, sensible. They are least in the royal kingdom of God, is greater than John the Baptist, who was an ideal rabbi. There you are. This is John the Baptist, a witness to the light, but not the light. And these are Christ Jesus and his brethren, twin brethren at Pentecost, when they received Holy Spirit as their reward. So they are the twin brother. Here you have a direct approach to God, and you need to be solitary. And here you are perfect in the moral laws, according to the scripture, that make you an angel. So the least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist. So this is a saint angel. Stephen was angel. Stephen was here, you know. And John the Baptist, he was sitting in the seat of John the Baptist. 70 outer circle laborers also belong to that John the Baptist. And here is the John the Baptist baptizing in water in the name of Abraham, born of water. Then only they can seek the narrow gate and become twice born, and where we have one father and we are all children, exercising love called agape love. Here arrows, agape. And then you have filial love and storge. All these things are very simple on your fingertips. If you have the longing for gospel, if you don't long for gospel, you won't get it. So be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken in two. That means master of the house. This is, I'm the master of my house here. This is my house. That means if I know when the thief is coming, that means I'm alert. I'm not sleeping. I am twice born. When you are twice born, you are alert. And you have the armor of His word. As I have put on this one, this is the armor of His word. Then you are alert. Then the thief can't touch you. He would not have let his house be broken in two. Are so far the saints, the royal priests are awake and active. They would not let the thief break into the church of God. But as soon as they were not awake, you know, after the death of Jesus and apostles, the church, you know, was left and it degraded. So when they were not awake, then those sacked temple priests, the husbandmen of the wine press, or the school of theology that coined the moral laws. Good for nothing for a job other than a priest. They were the thieves who jumped over the wall, over the walls of the fold Church of God by jumping over the walls. By jumping over the walls and occupied the house much cleaner than what they have left under rabbinic system. Matthew 12 verse 43 to 45 describes it. The situation became worse, and the docular priests, they are the generation of those crook priest who jumped wall, who were a thief. They did not enter through the proper gate where Peter was the gatekeeper. He would not have allowed any hypocrite or any blasphemer into the church. But they jumped over the wall like a thief. They were not the proper one. They bring in the Jewish leaven, the scripture, to poison the Church of God, where gospel was getting written over the hearts. Gospel is preached from heart to heart, explaining everything. You don't need any knowledge at all. That is why at Cana, when Jesus brewed the new wine, he asked the laborer to rinse out all the specks of the old wine from the stone vat. This is the stone vat. And put clean water in it. Make the heart of the person like that of a little child, unbiased, impartial. And then through, by the yeast of Holy Spirit, which is common sense, you brew logo, or His word, through logical reasoning. And that is gospel, good news, new wine. They bring in the Jewish leaven, the scripture, to poison the Church of God, where gospel was getting written over the hearts. You also must be prepared for an hour. You do not expect the Son of Man will come. That means you should be alert, you know, spiritually alert. So if somebody come to deliver the gospel, you should be alert to receive it, not reject it. If you are drunk with the old wine of the dead letters, then you won't desire it, the new one. I have gone to churches, you know, wherever I go, and tell them the parables, explain them the parables. They will be just stunned and they will be looking Bible, where to find it. They don't know that gospel is not written in the Bible. It's hidden under the scripture. Scripture are the reflection of the gospel. Unless God gave you by grace the Holy Spirit to dig out these treasures from the field, you won't get it. So there you need to dig them out of the scripture. They are there. I ask people, you know, the theologians, who was the father of the prodigal son and who was his elder brother? None of them know. Such a simple parable. The father is Abraham, the elder brother is Ishmael, and the younger one is Isaac. And Isaac people went for exile into Egypt. And over there they were maltreated, and Moses brought them back. The same land became lush green. I have explained this one, but no customer. Because gospel, unless father gave you, you can't have it. You can hear it, you won't understand it. You will see, scripture is seeing, you know, letters, but you won't be able to perceive it. Perceive means dig out the meaning of those parables. Then Peter said, Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone? Now Peter was once born of all the 12 laborers of Jesus. Peter was the only one who was once born, and he will say to call Jesus a Lord. Lord has slaves, and brother, father has sons. For twice born, Jesus was anointed elder brother. For Peter, he was a Lord, because he was once born. That's why he was hanged upside down. And our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus, and not the Lord that have slaves, as the rabbis had replied, who then is the faithful, a prudent steward, whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute food allowance, gospel treasures, by explaining the parables at the proper time? Remember that Peter was the one who fed the church, who took the sheep and put them into the church. And before he put them, he wetted them. Any blasphemer, he killed them. Ananias and Sapphira, they were blasphemers. They knew. They were old enough to know, they were not innocent. So they went against the Holy Spirit, which is in the heart, and presented to Peter, oh, this is the sale. They kept back money. Peter asked them twice, and twice they denied. That means they were doing the wrong thing knowingly. They were blasphemers, hypocrites. So Jesus killed them. No hypocrite is allowed into the church. If you want to form a church, then keep clear of the hypocrites. You need to be genuine seekers. So Peter was the one who was feeding sheep into the church of God by killing those which were antichrist, which were blasphemers, hypocrites. And today these churches are full of hypocrites, blasphemers, plenty of them. So that's why, you know, you don't get peace of mind, sectarian riots and all that, as in Ireland, Catholic and Protestant. Same Christ Jesus, they have formed cults or branches in his name, and they are fighting for nothing. At the proper time, blessed is that servant as Peter was, blessed that whom his master on arrival finds doing so. That means, doing so means he is preaching the gospel, are keeping Church of God free of the vultures. They are vultures, you know, these hypocrites, like these dog collar priests. They are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. Judas Iscariot used to steal money from the church purse, the purse he was holding. And these dog collar priests, people donate money. Royal priests give the money, they don't take money out of the church. And there you are, the thief with the dog collar. He steal money from the church purse. He is Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. So what can you expect then of such a church? They are blind, spiritually blind, they are not awake. So thief can come and plunder them, as the dog collar priests are doing. Truly I say to you, he will put him in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, my master is delayed in coming, and begins to beat the men servants and the maid servants to eat and drink and get drunk, then the servant's master will come on an unexpected day. That is Pope, you know. Pope has so many people serving them. So he is not the type of servant Jesus wants. He is a cruel master. Remember how he burned the people at stake, killed them by throwing them before animals to be eaten alive. And today he put on this uniform and killing again. Royal priests, they are free men, they are solitary. Unless you are solitary, you can't enter through this narrow gate. Royal priests enter this one, and here they are. They graft themselves to this true wine to suck the food. This is their daily bread. They take it and come out and preach gospel. And will punish him severely, as in the sectarian riots you will see how the people will be punished, and assign him a place with the unfaithful. So such people are unfaithful. Pope, Antichrist, Docal priest, they are Antichrist. So they are among the unfaithful people. And those who attend them, they are stooges, they are spiritually blind. They are not awake. That servant who knew his master's will but did not make preparation or put light under bushel, or he put the light under bushel, you know, nor act in accord with his will, shall be beaten severely for his psychic, stonic activities. So this is a bit, you know, let me explain this one clearly. So this is Trinity here, and very easy to understand, not difficult. So these are the once born people, once born, and by grace we become twice born here, doubting. Doubting, they are afraid to speak out gospel truth in case the authority beat them. And here they are sealed to serve God. They listen and they preach gospel. This one put light under bushel, frightened of the people, such as A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. Not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. None of these politicians or any docolo priest can proclaim this one, because they are frightened that if they proclaimed in the church, they will be hue and cry, he will be sacked. They are working for money and not for God. So they are frightened. So there are people who do not know gospel, they will be less severely beaten. And those people who know the gospel but hide it under bushel, they will be very severely beaten. And here they are, they have put the armor of his word. They are safe and sound. My father had this knowledge. So 2,000 people came to attack our village. And when my father told the attacking party that Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, they are spiritual self, never born, never die. We tribal people are going to kill each other. If you have enmity, let's fight. The attacking party had said, we don't have any enmity, we are friends. And he came as foe, he returned as our best friend. That is the armor of his word. If you put on, then you can live in peace, otherwise you will suffer. It's very interesting, but you need to have a seminar and something like this, so I can explain everything from the very root. Then we are, although we are solitary, then we will be of one accord. So Bush shall not act in accord with his will. With his will shall be beaten severely for his psychic satanic activities. And the servant who was ignorant, ignorant as the children are, you know, ignorant against the moral law, when they do, they go against the moral law in ignorance, then they commit sin. If they know the moral law, but they do it as the rabbis did it, they were hypocrite, they were not ignorant, they were blasphemers. So these church people, they know that royal priest, Jesus has set us free, we are royal priests, we should have fellowship. If still they have this same system as rabbinic, these are new rabbis in dog collar, then they are going against the will of our father, and they will suffer, sectarian riots, as they did in Northern Ireland, Catholic and Protestant. They are both blind, led by their blind guides. And the servant who was ignorant of his master's will, that means of once-born people who do not know his master's will or God's will, his word, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be beaten only lightly. That means those people, although they are deserving, you know, they should be beaten because they don't know the thing, but they will be not as severely beaten as those who put the light under bushel. That way Thomas said, the light came among his own and his own loved darkness. And those people, you know, who understood the gospel but put it under bushel, they will suffer heavily. Be beaten only lightly because he was once born, incapable of understanding his word. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much. That means twice born, sealed to serve God, and still more will be demanded of the person interested with more. He is the one which is interested with more, Holy Ghost, led by Holy Ghost, wise men, the people possessed with Holy Ghost, then he, from more is expected of him, preaching gospel. Gospel is double-edged sword, and then he himself is getting salvation and he rendering other people services to have salvation if they preach gospel. Gospel is the light of our supernatural Father, and we become the sons of the Most High only when we preach gospel, not otherwise. That is, we should put his prayers into practice to make more laborers for our royal vineyard. For our royal vineyard, where the true vine cry Jesus is planted, we need more laborers. Here, you need to be solitary. So, that's the gospel of our supernatural Father, and it's very easy if you have the longing for gospel. You must understand the Trinity, which I have in description at the bottom of my description of this video, and you will enjoy it. Our Father God blesses you.